The thing that's really most kind of captivating about building stuff and creating is exploring places allows you to see things from a whole different way. It's just kind of proved to us that they're not just a fun machine. They're actually in a brilliant way of experiencing and exploring an environment. And the people you work with get a great thrill out of it, and the people who use the equipment get a great thrill out of it. And I love that fact that you can share all that enjoyment and that sort of thrill with other people.
Agua, agua. 3, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3.
It's so surreal. 24 hours ago, I was in the quietest part of England at Parajet in Dorset, and now I'm here in this vibrant, loud market, and I'm so excited. Daniel, you know the best part about being in northern Brazil is that two whole Parajet travel kits fit perfectly inside this car. It's like made for it.
Hello, mate. What's this place called again?
The city's Barreirinhas, the state of Maranhão.
Oh, poor little donkeys. Let's go. I see some water. It looks like we found a quiet spot to set up. Set the maker up, set the paramotors up. When I see people looking at me with a surfboard, they probably think I'm crazy, but little do they know, I've got an engine in it. I don't need any surf.
Parajet mudou minha vida. Não me vejo mais hoje em nenhum lugar sem levar meu paramotor. E a coisa mais incrível da Parajet é a perfeição em todos os detalhes. Você chega aqui, pega tudo na mala, tudo encaixa perfeitamente. Essa geometria desenvolvida no CNC é perfeita, não tem falha, não tem erro. Você chega aqui em 20 minutos, você monta tudo, você se prepara, você decola, tudo funciona e você só vai buscar a felicidade.
This is so exciting. Apparently this area is renowned for its beautiful, beautiful sand dunes, and I haven't seen any of it yet. I've met this helicopter pilot. The Mako fits perfectly inside his chopper. And we're gonna go and see what we can find. It feels a bit like heli skiing, only we're in the tropics and there's no snow, there's only sand and beautiful lagoons. I just love that I'm here. It's such an incredible landscape, pristine dunes and empty lagoons. It's just unbelievably beautiful. Mako is the perfect way to explore. Cruise around the lagoon, explore it, and then walk over sand dunes to the next lagoon. There's thousands of them waiting to be explored. In this pristine landscape, it's the perfect playground.
I find myself here in northern Brazil on the edge of a huge river delta, and it's so hot on this jetty, I'm standing here like a cat on a hot tin roof. So do I jetboard, do I fly? Do you know what? I'll take the jetboard, cool the feet off, and come back for a flight. This place is just the ultimate for exploring. I just found a shipwreck while I was flying, so now I'm going to jump on the jetboard and go and check it out a bit closer up. The jetboard is a new thing for us because you don't really need any formal training. Anybody can pretty much jump on it with a quick brief and go and have some fun. And this has opened up a whole new way of sharing what I do. never spent so much time riding the Mako. And I've gone through mangroves, you know, narrow gullies where I'm chasing birds, and then all of a sudden it opens up to the ocean and this sand dune's just popping up out of nowhere. I feel like I've really explored this place from the water, but now it's time to get a flight in. Awesome day.
About a year ago, I saw a tiny little picture of these turquoise lagoons and these dunes. I thought, where the hell is that place? It's just miles and miles of dunes and lagoons, and I just can't wait to get down there. This plane has got everything I need for fun. I've arrived here with a Parajet and a jetboard tucked in the back of this little plane, right in the middle of what feels like kind of just coming across the middle of the desert. It's just unbelievable. Daniel!
Welcome to Brazil!
How are you doing? Good to meet you. This is how the door is kept on. Can you imagine? Perfect. Arriving here, we had the jet boards in the water, we had Parajets up in the sky taking off from the dunes, and the brilliant thing was that we had this little town where we were, and all the people were lining up on the side of the docks, just whooping and screaming and cheering of these people whizzing around and having just mayhem.
We manufacture these machines, and I work in an office 5 days a week. But what we're really selling is this, the possibility of the adventure.
Inspiration is one of the most important things for all of us. It's really important for us to be able to leave the computers, the cell phones, the factory behind, and come into this place together and really allow inspiration to kind of flourish.
On machines that we like to make, one important factor is being able to travel with it. You pull them out of the bags, you build them up, and you go and explore in a completely different environment. Being easy to travel with means that you get to experience completely different places.
just been cruising down this river for about probably 5 hours in the morning. I think we've got maybe one of our buddies here about to take off. Oh, yes, look at him.
They're having so much fun on the Mako boards. They are zipping around this river. You can't get them off of it. I really want to go, but I can't get them off.
Compelled to invent ways or develop and improve things all the time to help us experience this amazing planet in different ways. To be able to do this with all this stuff, and we're in this era now where we've got so many cool things we can do in the way of bringing materials together and people together to make cool stuff happen. So I just feel so privileged, really. So we've got 5 Parajets. We're about to take off. Hopefully see in the distance these beautiful white sand dunes. Conditions are perfect. All the machines are here working. Jet boards and the truck ready to be taken out there. Couldn't be better. So lucky. Absolutely amazing.
Okay, so today's super exciting. I get to take my new wife, Alex, tandem over the most special place I think I've ever seen. And I get to do it with all my friends and colleagues.
Everyone's just taken off, and I've been asked to bring the boards and the fuel and meet them in the dunes. So I guess I've got a 2-hour rough ride ahead of me. We've got the high-tech jet boards, really slick, straight out of the factory, brand new. And then we're on metal welded together barge with an engine that's in a boat next to it, pushing it along.
When you look at the surroundings around you, this fantastic country, the diversity of the landscape it has, it is mind-blowing.
Who is the director of a paramotor company, one of the most satisfying things, apart from the feeling of flying one, it is to see the guys make this in the factory, and then we are life testing these products right here. Planes, trains, buses, vans, you name it, it's been everywhere. And these bits of equipment never let us down. It's absolutely fantastic. It's a real feeling of pride to know that we've created something and then we've come here to have fun with it.
Yeah. by far the best flight I've ever done.
Ever.
I do it with you, Babs. Mwah.
We've been up for about 2 hours in this unbelievable playground for paramotors. Literally foot dragging over the dunes, over the water, diving down, it's just endless fun.
The best thing for me about this flight was simply flying with my colleagues in a really cool place. I'm used to flying with them at home, but sharing a place like this was just fantastic. Now I think it's time for some jet boarding.
The world is filled with incredible places. It's filled with amazing views and beautiful places. But to add that other dimension of being able to race through it and explore it and see it from a totally different perspective, it really does allow you to, I think, appreciate the planet more than you can just standing on your own, seeing a beautiful place, or just dipping your toes in a beautiful water. You know, you can actually be fully part of it. The Parajet and the jetboard have just been fantastic tools with which to experience the environment, the massive expanses of dunes and lagoons here. I mean, just fantastic ways to get around and see them in a way you would never otherwise be able to see them.
These machines are things that we created together, and we're all on a trip enjoying it. It's absolutely brilliant. I think I need to go again. We found the perfect place to stay last night.
And these lovely hammocks all lined up like we're in some dormitory. And then we've woken up to this just amazing scenery. And we're gonna go and play with the jet boards and just whiz around, and this is what it's all about. This couldn't be more perfect. Months and months designing, manufacturing and testing all of these components, and to bring these machines out here for the ultimate test, whether it be land, water, we're absolutely pushing them to their limits as much as we can and enjoying ourselves.
arrived in Rio last night. We got up early this morning and we're hoping to get up close and personal with the Christ.
I didn't even know we were going to be doing this. It's a complete unbelievable bonus for sure. I'm so excited about it.
It's quite a technical flight because pretty much once you take off, you've got to get some height, and there's very few landing spots on the way there, unless you're going to go and land in some kind of favela or in some kind of jungle. So.
We've just been making a plan with some local pilots, because obviously their knowledge about this area is much greater than any of ours.
Above these mountains and from there, we go by the sea.
For a flight here in Rio, it's not a perfect day. Big, huge clouds, windy. Off we go and explore the city. This is the most amazing urban flight you can possibly do. Fly over the city of Rio de Janeiro, hoping to get the Christ the Redeemer, the Corcovado statue. Doing this with friends, there's just nothing better. There goes Gilo, Gilo above me. Hey Gilo, welcome to my home, Rio de Janeiro. Corcovado, the magnificent statue of Corcovado. The symbol of Rio de Janeiro, and here we are with our Parajets. It doesn't get any better. It's dramatic. It's beautiful. Traveling the world for the past 30 years filming, I always had a desire to be up in the sky to be able to get my aerial footage. Now, I cannot imagine myself traveling without.
Go to Rio without seeing the Sugarloaf from a jetboard. It's like not going to Rio. It's so awesome that we've literally turned up the two Mako jetboards in the back of a taxi in the middle of Rio, popped into the harbour and just jetted off past the Sugarloaf. There was a girl. It's quite scary sometimes. You're going around these massive rocks and there's chop and there's a massive great big super tanker going by and it's like, this is insane. We just arrived here. We can chuck these things on an aeroplane and just turn up and see the city like no other way. Shaking with and then you go past Gakagabana. It's been such a cool experience. And it's just the most amazing way to be able to just turn up in the city.
This is high-speed tourism. We set off from Sugarloaf, and then we jetboarded across the famous seafronts, ending up on Ipanema at 34 miles an hour. And there is just not a better way to see Rio de Janeiro. I think amongst our group, we always take our work home with us because we find ourselves talking about the same thing in the evening over a beer.
I'm so subconsciously thinking about everything all the time that naturally gets driven into the design. So those design solutions aren't just thought from 9 to 5. They're thought 24/7.
Yeah, we hear stories from other customers of their journeys and their adventures, but to do it ourselves and to see our own equipment perform so beautifully is hugely satisfying.
It's so exhilarating when you see it all come together. And so often, it doesn't always work first time. So often it doesn't work after, you know, a year or two of trying. But eventually, when you get everything together and it does all work, it's just wonderfully rewarding. It's a never-ending quest, in a way, but that's part of what's so exciting about it.